It was a tiny, blink-and-you'll-miss-it type of clip from Dr. Michael Greger in a recent interview, where he dropped a quite surprising piece of information about a popular fruit, and he sounded quite downbeat about it, as this fruit was in his top three favourite fruits to eat. But has a new study featured in How Not to Age changed that? Well, we're going to listen to two clips from Dr. Greger that may shed light on all of this. Before I'd heard that clip, I was planning on making a positive video about this particular fruit, based on a fascinating study published in March 2025. So let's take a look at the study and then we'll hear those clips from Dr. Greger. Researchers recruited women aged 50 to 70 for a 4-week trial, and the participants attended 3 study visits. They were not allowed to eat mangoes at least a week before the first visit or during the study. Participants also submitted sets of food logs. At the first visit, health measurements were taken, and then 2 hours later, these were repeated to check for any changes. 2 weeks later, participants ate 330 grams of mango, which is roughly 2 cups. Researchers conducted health checks before participants ate mango and 2 hours after. They were then asked to eat 1 packet of frozen mango, 330 grams, daily for the next 2 weeks, half in the morning and the other half in the evening. At the last visit, after another overnight fast, the same health checks were repeated. Participants ate mango again and more measurements were taken 2 hours later. Researchers also conducted a follow-up trial with just 6 participants. Measurements and blood samples were taken before they ate anything, then again 1 hour and 2 hours later. On one visit, they ate fresh mango pulp. On another visit, they ate white bread with similar calories and carbohydrates as the mango. Measurements were repeated at the same time intervals after eating to study any changes. And what the researchers found was that eating mangoes had specific effects on the heart. They found that after eating mango pulp, arterial stiffness was reduced by 35% to 38% 2 hours later during both mango eating periods. Now, arterial stiffness is a measurement of the flexibility of your blood vessels and how easily they respond to changes in blood pressure. Stiff arteries can be a risk factor for heart disease. After 2 weeks of daily mango intake, blood pressure after meals improved, with systolic blood pressure dropping significantly compared to the no mango period, as it decreased by 6 millimeters of mercury. Diastolic blood pressure also lowered slightly by 2.7 millimeters of mercury. 2 weeks of mango eating was also associated with a drop in cholesterol levels, which decreased by 9 milligrams per deciliter. LDL cholesterol decreased by 9.6 milligrams per deciliter 2 hours after eating mango. After 2 weeks, participants' blood sugar levels were noticeably lower 2 hours after eating, compared to when they hadn't started the mango routine yet. It's important to note that the study was funded in part by the National Mango Board. But now let's hear from Dr. Greger.
Ah, I love mangoes. I was so sad about that. There was some bad mango study in the skin chapter or something. I was just like, God damn it. Anyway, but look, I may have my biases, but you gotta, the science is the science. Pomegranates, pomegranate season right now. Ooh, amazing. And then if I had to pick third, well, I'm a big fan of sweet tango apples. You gotta get them in season, but yeah, good stuff. The only other interventional food study on wrinkles I could find tested one of my favorite fruits, mangoes. Light-skinned postmenopausal women were randomized to eat about a half a cup of champagne mango, or around a cup and a half every day for 16 weeks. Lucky ducks. Unfortunately, as an exploratory study, there was no usual diet control group, but compared to baseline, the deep wrinkle severity in the half-cup group significantly decreased by week 8 and remained so for the duration of the study. In contrast to the funding National Mango Board's chagrin, average wrinkle severity got worse by the end of the 16 weeks in the cup and a half group. The researchers suggested it might have been due to the extra sugar intake, but there wasn't actually any changes in blood sugar levels, so it remains a mystery.
So after all of that, it seems if you're concerned about your skin, perhaps there are better fruits to consume. But if you're not fussed, then mangoes are thankfully still an amazing option. Now there's a fruit that is a mitochondrial poison, and yet Dr. Greger recommends we still eat it. To find out why and what this fruit is, you can click the middle of the screen now.